Yo, what is up, guys? Back for another video. And today's video, obviously, Tower of God episode 4, The Green April. Honestly, again, similar to like the previous episodes, this one's very content related, but we get more of like the jihad story in this one. And we basically get the story about the marches, the months. So the weapon that Bomb has and Anak, they're called the months. So there's like the Green April we've seen so far. We've seen April and we've seen March. We haven't seen, you know, January or February. We haven't seen the other weapons basically. And I'm assuming that other princesses have 1 month each to them. I'm assuming. Maybe Yuri has more, I don't know. There appears to be more than 12 princesses, at least to what the story's been telling us so far. So this story we get, again, character development, but from a different team. We get it from Anak's team. So Anak, Hatsu, and then that one comedic relief martial artist guy. I don't know his name yet. I mean, I can't remember his name off the top of my head. So this episode starts continuation from the last one, from the game, the Crown game. And we find out that there is a Shinsu user hidden amongst them. The guy who sleeps in the bed, or who sleeps all the time, basically. He's a wave controller. That's what they called him. And we find out that Anak is very, according to Leorio, that she's very like immature when it comes to using the weapon. He was very disappointed in her because of how she used it. She used ignition mode. I'm guessing that's like the weapon released. It's like a weapon release,
I'm trying to think of something like Bankai,
maybe, I don't know. Maybe it's like a Bankai or something. Maybe, I don't know. We're not sure yet, but we know there's some mode called ignition mode release. We know that this weapon centralized around her wanting that weapon when she realized she could sense it amongst Bomb, because his weapon was reacting to hers. So maybe the months are related. Obviously they're related by the name, but like maybe they have like a link of some sort. But other than that, we find out that that is actually Rachel. I call her Rachel, I don't care. And there is another character who called Anak an imposter. So we get more mystery into Anak's character when she proclaimed she was a princess of Jihad. She said it. Leorio said it too. He said it as well. So I'm assuming she is, but there's some story there that makes her a quote-unquote imposter. So how about Rachel's decision at the end of the episode, or Rahel, whatever. We're getting more and more into who she is as a character, literally. Like, so far, if we were to define her character, we'd say she's nice, she was a role model, but now when she, you know, when she sees Bomb and she's like, and when that one lady said, is it okay to kill everybody? And she said, yes. I'm like, you know that's Bombs. So why are you trying to kill him? That's what I'm getting at, honestly. And I mean, at the end of the episode, let me know what you guys thought about the episode. I think it was good character development. I think it was good for the arc. I think it was good for the weapons to be introduced. Ignition mode. It's good that we got more characters in here, like Hatsu and Anak. You know, it's good that we have more characters. But like, we can always tell when those gates opened. We know that those are side characters, like the four eyes guy, the little rabbit lady at the end who was jumping, the girl who can use the wand to control Shinsu. We know they're side characters, like, you just know with the show. But like, those characters that stick around, their character development is insane so far, and I I appreciate writing like that. So let me know what you guys think about the episode. Let me know what you guys think about Rahel's decision. Let me know what you guys think in general about like this whole show so far. I'm getting like Hunter vibes still, but like I know for a fact it steers off into its own path later on. But like again, I feel Hunter vibes. But let me know what you guys think, and yeah, peace.